Today, we're back with one of my favorite series. I'm going to be playing the most popular One Piece games on Roblox, but that's not all. In each game we play, I'm going to be obtaining and mastering the control fruit, and also give each game a rating out of 10 to find out which one has the best control. And for the first game, King's Legacy. Now, it's been a while since I've hopped onto this game. I think I might already have the Ope fruit. So we have Snow, Brachio, Gum, Gravity, Barrier, and I lied. I do not have the Ope fruit. Okay, so as usual, we have to go to the Starter Island because that's the only island with a gacha on it. Now, I have no idea how rare the Ope fruit is, but I guess we're about to find out. Is this dude walking on air? What the heck? Yo, Wesley4437. Guess I'm about to bring this dude along with me. Vamos trocar. I have no idea what he's saying. Here we go, though. We're pulling up to the Starter Island. Now let's go check at the black market. Let's see how rare the Ope fruit is. Hopefully, it's not too expensive. Ope right here. Okay, it's a rare. That's actually not too bad. Now, it is out of stock, so we are going to have to get it from the gacha. We have 120 gems, so we should be able to get a few spins. Wait a minute. This looks different. You can open one and open 10. Do they use keys now? Copper key, iron key, gold key. Did the currency change? What the heck? I thought you used to be able to buy gachas with gems. This is weird. Oh, I figured it out. To buy copper keys, you need 250,000 belly. To buy an iron key, you need 3 gems. To buy gold key, you need 15 gems. Okay, I have 120, so I could probably buy 7 of those. What if I just bought 5 gold keys and I just bought a bunch of irons? Let me open 10 chests. Oh, they have a new opening animation now. This is fire. Yo, King's Legacy got a crazy update. Okay, spin. Let's see what else we get. Wolf fruits. Yo, King's Legacy really updated their thing, bro. I didn't even know they had it like this for real. Okay. Sand fruit rare. We're cooking. Giraffe fruit. Another giraffe. Smoke. Spino. What is that? Okay. Spino again. And love. Damn, King Legacy really updated their game, bro. There's a lot I probably don't know about this game now. What the heck is that? What the heck is this man doing? King's Legacy did not look this good before. What the heck? Ain't no way. This game just got a Blox fruits level of rework right here, bro. I'm not gonna lie, we didn't get that many good fruits from that one. We did get one called the Spino fruit. I wanna check that one out, see what that's talking about. Spinosaurus. Okay, let me go to stats. We have 3,000 points. Might as well put that all in fruit. We have Roar, Terror Roar, Scratch, and Beast Mode. Okay, Spinosaurus. What the hell is that? Okay. The models look a lot better, though. I ain't gonna lie. This looks updated. Okay, does this thing have M1s? Oh, it does. Okay. You know what, bro? King's Legacy for the first time me doing one of these videos might get a high rating. Okay, let's check Roar out. That one still looks a little anticlimactic. What about Terror Roar? Maybe this one is better. Terror Roar? Okay, I mean, this is only a rare fruit, so maybe Ope is better. Maybe Ope is better. What about Scratch? Sing, sing. Okay, that wasn't that good. And then Beast Mode. What did I just do? Nothing happened. Do I just get like a buff or something with my moves? All right, I ain't gonna lie. Spino Fruit is not that good. Let's just continue rolling for the Ope. I did buy 5 gold ones, so I guess let's just open 5. Oh, I got Spirit. What the heck? An Epic? If we don't get Ope, we might have to check out the Spirit Fruit. Spring next. Next up, Gum Fruit Rare. Okay, Barrier. And one last gold key. Let's see what we get. Spike. Damn, we didn't even get the Ope. Curious to see how this does though, bro. Spirit. You know what, boys? You know what, bros? Let's just store that. For now, though, I need more gems. Robux, $20 package, authorizing payment, and 1,700 Robux. Okay, so now there's a 500 gem for 1,500 Robux package right here. Might as well buy that. 500 gems. That'll get us a lot of keys. Boom, gem spot. And you know what, boys? We're going all out. We ain't going to buy these little cheap keys. We buying the gold keys here, boys. 15 should be good. That should be more than enough. All right, let's open 10. Let's see what we get. Giraffe, spike, giraffe, sand. Ope, yes, sir. That was easy. We didn't even use the 10. Okay, let's see what we get for the rest of the 10 then. Ice, epic. I'll take that. Giraffe. Another bomb. Another epic. Damn, 2 epics in under 10. Okay. Let me go ahead and store this. And let me store this. But now we've got to eat the Ope fruit. This looks kind of weird. I ain't gonna lie. This doesn't look like the Ope fruit to me. Probably did this to avoid copyright. But without further ado, let's go ahead and eat that. King's Legacy, you've gotten some good reworks. Please don't disappoint me with the Ope fruit. Oh, we actually have a lot of different moves. Area, rock, heart, gamma, teleport, and counter shock. Okay. We got a lot of moves. Let's go ahead and test it off on this boss over here. Smokey, you're about to be my test dummy. All right. First move. Room. Oh, little holding animation. Okay, damn, that was already not that good. I'm gonna be honest. Let's see that again. Hold on, let's deactivate that room. Can't even really hold it for real. It's just like that, and then it just activates. I guess that's not terrible. All right, first up, we have rock. Boom. This is the same as Blox fruits. Okay, that's actually not that bad. Okay. All right, next up, we have heart. Ope, heart. What the heck was that? Okay, that thing had like absolutely no animation to it. All right, let's check out the rest of the moves here then. Heart once again. Oh, you do get the heart. Hold on, you get the heart right here. It's just, it shows up in your inventory, so I didn't see it. Wait, did it just auto kill him? Let me check this out on a more health boss. Okay, there's the heart right here. Let's take this. It still kills him. What the heck? Nah, that's OP, bro. We gotta try that for PvP, see if that works on a player later on. Still got a few moves left to check out, though. Let's check out teleport. Let's see how far this goes. Teleport. Okay, it goes for the whole room. Okay, not bad. We have gamma. Oh, little gamma knife. Gamma knife. That actually looks kind of fire. Okay, boom. Animation could be better, but not the worst thing I've seen. And last but not least, we have counter shock. I mean, it one-shotted him. Let's see if it one-shots the boss. Counter shock. Oh yeah, I one-shotted him. Okay, you know what? Just based off the how like the control looks. Bro, this is tough. Animations are not that good, I'm gonna be honest. I'm gonna have to give this one a 5 out of 10, bro. A 5 out of 10. Straight 50%. Cause it's just not that good. It's just not that good. I'm sorry, man. Now that last one was a little bit lackluster, being only a 5 out of 10, but let's see how good this next one is. For the next game, we have a One Piece game. And just for a little info on the game, the Operation Fruit is a mythical in this game, and it also has a Fruit Awakening. So this has got me a little hype for this one. It should be better. Now, I've played this game a lot, so there's no way I don't have an Ope Fruit. Let me just look in here. Ope, zero results. There's no shot. Maybe I have to type in the whole thing. Operation, zero result. That is crazy, bro. All the time I've been playing this game, I've never got an Ope. No worries for us. I've literally got 47 billion belly, so we could do a lot of fruit spins. It's no problem, to be honest. Let me go gear fifth, and let's go over to the island where the gacha is. There we go. Log Town. All right, perfect. Now, doing fruit gachas in this game is a lot easier than other games. You talk to this merchant right here, and you could literally type in the amount you want. I'm gonna type in 100 fruits. Let's see. Do I see any operations in here? No. I saw a mochi in there. Okay, okay. We got mochi already. That's good. I don't think I saw operation. Let me see. Nope, no opens. The game wants to play hard to get, eh? The game wants to play hard to get, eh? We could do this all day, boys. 100 more. Easy. No inventory space available. Okay, game's trolling me. All right, there we go. I cleared up majority. Now I only have 84. 100 more. Let's get it. Let's get it. Okay, let's see. I see invisible. I already see another mochi. I already saw 2 mochis in there. What the? How am I getting mochis this easily, but no control? No, don't tell me I don't get an ope. Oh my gosh. I saw 2 quakes in there. No ope. Oh, I just realized I can auto delete fruits. Okay, you know what? Let me auto delete barrier, chop, fire, ice, lightning, invisible, magma, phoenix, string, light. Let's just auto delete everything other than the one I need, bro. All right, let's go. Quake, Buddha, quake, king's fruit, quake. Out of 95 fruits, I only got those. Okay, buddy. Let's keep spinning. Let's keep spinning. Quake, 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 Buddha, 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 quake, 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 quake. All right, well, you know what, boys? I'm deleting quake, and I'm also deleting Buddha. We're only getting mythicals now, boys. And this time, we're buying 250. Did I actually just get nothing from that 100? That is actually insane, bro. It's 200 spins, and we didn't even get a single fruit. I'm getting scammed. I'm actually getting scammed. 200 more. Not even a single fruit from 200 more spins. I'm not giving up 200 more. Come on, come on. Operation, please. Mochi, and that's it. Another mochi. Damn, Ope, it better be the best fruit this game with how long this is taking, bro. I might just have to trade for it. I mean, I've got 2 dragons. I've got some rubber fruits. And I've got tons of mochis. So that could be a backup plan. If we can't get it from spinning, we could trade for it. 5 billion belly left. I can only afford 190 more spins. If I don't get this, I'm done with the belly, boys. We have to get it for a trade. I received a mochi. Come on. And another mochi. Let me type in chat. Anyone here got Ope for trade? Please, someone respond soon, man. This thing seems damn rare as hell, bro. With like how much that costed me.
A few minutes later.
Well, I've gone from server to server asking questions like, anyone got OP for trade, or can someone trade me OP? And no luck. I haven't even got a single response. Looks like we have to take matters into our own hands. We've got to make our way to Second Sea and grind out a bunch of belly, because we're going to get this through gacha no matter what.
3 hours later. All
right, boys, I'm fighting a boss. And after I kill this one, I think we'll have enough belly. There we go. We're now at 47 billion belly. That is more than enough to do some more spinning. Here we go, boys. Here we go. This is going to be the one, boys. 47 billion belly. There's no way we don't get a single ope. We're gonna block out all of these fruits. There we go. 200 fruits. Come on, come on. Please give me one. Please give me one ope out of this. Oh, we got an ope. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Oh my gosh, boys. I was so worried we were not about to get another one, but it looks like we finally did. Over like 2 hours of grinding for belly just to get this damn thing, bro. Kind of crazy when you think about it, man. All right, so first things first, I have to switch over to a different fruit and reset this one. And now let's eat the operation fruit. This one's accurate to the heart. Let's waste no more time though. Let's go ahead and eat that thing. Yes, sir. This better be worth it, all the damn time I spent grinding. Let's see all the moves. Cut, room, shambles, tact, counter shock, and mess. Now that's not that many moves, but don't forget this has an awakening. So first off, we have room. There we go. Let's see how long can you hold that. Okay, you can't hold that very long. So this is the biggest the room can get. Next up, we have shambles. I guess this is a teleport. Oh, that thing has no cooldown. Yo, you can just literally spam this thing. Okay, okay. That gets extra points for usability. Can it go the full duration of the room? Let me see. Oh, it can. Okay, that's fire. That's fire. Next up, we have this ability named Cut M1. What do you do with that? It's not really doing anything. Okay, that's weird. Next up, we have Tact. Oh, what the heck? Oh, wait a minute. I think the Cut and the Tact tie together. That's actually weird. I guess that's cool, but I don't really like the way that's used. It literally 2 moves in one. So 2 of these moves are wasted. Next up, we have Mez. I'm assuming this is the heart one. Oh, yeah, it's the heart one right there. And if I click it, damn, that did a lot of damage. Okay. Well, last but not least, we have Counter Shock. Oh, goes up in the air. Oh, that's actually not that bad of an animation. All right, all right. So the control's not too bad in base form. It's also not that good, but I would at least say the control in base form's slightly better than King's Legacy. Not by much, though. But now let's go figure out how to awaken it. Now, according to the wiki, in order to obtain the Ope fruit, what you need to do is obtain something something called a true Kikoku scroll, and you also need to have 33,000 gems to fully evolve it. And to get your scroll, what you need to do is defeat the Wicked Law boss, and it has a 5% drop chance. So yeah, this is gonna be tough. For this one though, I ain't gonna lie, I'm switching back over to gear 5, that way we can actually do some damage. I believe this is the Land of Judgment right here, boys. Hopefully we can hang with this boss. There we go, Land of Judgment. Now where is he at? There's Beppo right there, and here's the Awakened Law boss. Look at that bounty, bro. Damn. Well, let's waste no more time. Let's go ahead and try to fight this boy right here. Can't be too damn hard. Damn, did he just almost one-shot me? Hold on. Jump to liberation. There we go. Let's heal up. Let me try getting close. Let's see how much damage did I deal with all that. Oh, he's actually not that strong. Okay. He's actually feasible. All right, hold on. Let me heal up. Wait, did I just kill him right there? That was pretty anticlimactic, I'm not gonna lie. He didn't drop the scroll, though, or at least I think he didn't. Yep, he didn't drop the scroll. Okay, now I guess we just gotta keep fighting him until we get it.
A few minutes later.
And there we go, boys. True Kikoku scroll. This actually didn't take me that long to get. I think I was only grinding for about 30 minutes, but we got it. Now all we gotta do is go back to Log Town, and then we can evolve this Ope. But first, we need to buy the 33,000 gems, because these boys are money hungry, bruh. That's gonna be like almost 100 bucks worth of Robux, bro. That's actually crazy. What are these boys thinking? This thing better be the best damn fruit in the game for the way all this is crying. Mythical, which took us like 1,000 spins to get. We had to grind for like an hour just to get the scroll, and you gotta spend $100 worth of Robux to get all the gems needed. This is actually ridiculous, man. All right, this is the last bit of gems. 33,000. There we go. I can't believe I actually just spent $100 for that. That is actually insane. Gems merchant. There we go. I awaken a move. Let's just go ahead and just hurry up and awaken the rest of them. Next one here. Third one. There we go. Fifth. I think we got 3 more to go through. There we go. 1, 2, and last ability right here, boys. There we go. And before we even get to the move showcase, bro, I just must say, these game devs are actually the most money-hungry, greedy, grubby game devs I've ever seen. I don't even use this account, and literally just off this one game alone, I had to spend 8,363 Robux. And I haven't logged in this account in months, so it's all from this game. Golly, man. Like, how greedy do you gotta be, man? Well, without any further delay, let's go ahead and check this move set out. Alright, so we've got a bunch of new abilities. Kikoku Cut, Counter Shock, Whirlwind, Amputate, Shock Willy, Puncture Willy, and Re-Room. Also, I noticed, yo, you got a sword now just by pulling that thing out.
I like that.
Oh, and when you get Kikoku Cut, hold on, let me see what his damage that does, bro. Boom. Oh, that actually one shots. That's crazy. Okay, that's fire. First move, we have our room. Okay, let's use that our room. Wait, what the heck? Is it an attack with it? Oh, it's a shootable attack, and wherever you shoot it, that's where the room activates. And this room is like twice the size of the other one. Already off to a good start. Next up, we got Counter Shock. Okay, let's check that Counter Shock. Oh, damn, no animation, just straight up kills him. Okay, I'm messing with that. Next up, we have Whirlwind. Okay, let's aim that over there. Oh, damn. Okay. Yo, the animations, they actually cooked a little bit with the animations. Next up, we have Amputate. I'm assuming this is probably like the heart one. Oh, it literally takes the heart out of everybody in the damn room. Animation-wise, that one wasn't like the craziest, but like, I'm just amazed. Like, this thing could be crazy for grinding in this game. Next up, we have Shock Willy. Oh, you teleport to him? It's like a gamma knife. You teleport to him, shock him with that thing, it'd explode him. And it had a massive AoE too. One more time, Shock Willy. Teleport to him, pack him up. I like that. Last but not least, we have Puncture Willy. I'm assuming this is gonna be the ultimate or something. Let's see how that is. Puncture Willy, I'm the surgeon of death. Oh wait, we have a little cutscene. What the hell? This is like a goofy cutscene, huh? I thought they were cooking with that cutscene, but they like messed up the POV or something. They was not cooking with that. I ain't gonna lie, they was not cooking with that. Overall though, I ain't gonna lie, like, this may be the best a One Piece game fruit we've seen on the channel yet. I'm gonna give this an 8 out of 10. I have to. Next up though, we have Fruit Battlegrounds. Now the Ope fruit in this game is actually a mythical, and it's 0.03%, which is why I did my preparation, and I had the Ope fruit beforehand. You guys can see right here, got it in my inventory already. Now, fortunately, I also do already have this thing fully maxed out. I did in a video before. So what we're gonna do is just do a move showcase, and we'll get a few kills with it. Now, if you look down the bottom, we have Room, Tact, Wreckage, Hurricane Shock, Gamma Knife, Mez, and Shambles, which seems to be that similar moves as all the other ones are running. So let's go ahead and showcase on this noob right here. Unfortunately, a little noob. So you can hold the room, and I think it makes it go a lot bigger. Yep, this is kind of crazy. First off, we have Shambles, which can go the entire duration of the move and also has a pretty short cooldown. Next up, we have Tact, which is the rocks. And basically, you just double click to shoot them towards something. Next up, we have Wreckage, which makes a rock shoot off the ground and kind of just lunges them up. And also a cool hidden tech that a lot of people don't know about. Tact and Wreckage actually work together. Let me show y'all real quick. So let me throw out Tact, right? You see that the rocks are floating. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to throw a Wreckage on this guy right here. Boom, hit him with that. And the Tact automatically hitting combos with the wreckage. Also, we just killed that guy. Next up, we have Hurricane Shock. You basically pick him up and hold him in this little hurricane. You can hold him there and hit him as long as you want. You do like a little bit of damage. But once you stop, you lunge on top of him, hit him with that little thunder move, and you can combo him with that. Next up, we have Mez. Lunge at him, grab the heart, and if you click it, it stuns him. Then you could do an M1 combo because it stuns him. You can only do a maximum of 3 clicks per heart, though, and the heart also disappears after a while. Last but not least, we have Gamma Knife. You hit him like that, and it stuns him very long, which allows you to combo into literally basically anything. So I'm not gonna lie, the moveset for this one is very good, both in terms of visually and like just actually good at the game. But now that we got that out the way, let's go get 5 kills. Oh, we got a noob over here. What's good? He just ran the safe zone. Did he just hit me, bro? Are you good, bro? Are you good? You know, you're not gonna just do this, right? Boom, 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 boom. Gamma knife and GG. Just 1 kill down, 4 more to go. We got a lot of players over here. What's good, G? Boom. Hit him like this. Gamma knife. Boom. Hurricane shock. Hit him there. 2nd kill. All these boys just chilling outside my room, bro. Get back over here, buddy. Get back over here, bucko. Sorry, buddy. You're gonna have to get the craziest stray right there, buddy. Uh-oh. No. This dude's getting brave. What? He's leopard? Oh my god. We may not be able to kill this boy. I'm just getting wall cobbled out. Bro. What? Get him there. Get him with these. Okay, that's the 3rd kill. All right. Who's that? We're gonna do this. Boom. Got him there, sniped him. All right, buddy. I know you're a leopard and everything. I'm gonna keep messing him like this. Hold on. Watch this, boys. Hit him with the Mez. Yep, buddy. Boom. Get my knife. Sheesh. Straight in the hurricane shock. 4th kill, buddy. That is actually toxic. That is so toxic, bro. We just need 1 more kill to go. Let me try going up here. Let's see if we can find someone up here. I see someone down there. What's good, my G? What is good? Oh, it's the leopard. All right, bet. Let's get this room activated. I see 2 people. We can jump them. All righty. Boom. Hit him with that Mez. Get my knife. Counter shock. Boom. Killed 1. Killed 2. You know what? Might as well go for the whole entire party right here while we're at it. Boom. 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 Oh, damn. Okay, he actually fighting back. Get back there. Boom. Hit him with that. Hit him with these. And final kill down. I ain't gonna lie, man. OP in this game. This is kind of toxic, bro. Sheesh. This thing OP. I mean, it's a mythical for a reason. Don't get me wrong. I'm giving this one a straight 9 out of 10. Not just for visuals, because even though visually it is fire, I just think everything pairs together well. It's overall just really good in the game on top of the visuals. So to recap, for King's Legacy, we gave that a 4. For a One Piece game, we gave that an 8. And this one, we gave that a 9. We do have 1 game left, though, boys. And let's see how that works. And for the final game, obviously, we have Blox Fruits. Now, normally I'd have permanent control and it'd be fully mastered out on my main, but today we're on this alt account, so y'all get to watch me mash out the whole thing. Fortunately, I don't have the physical version of it, so we've got to trade for it. I think we should be able to do that though with Shadow. So let me type in chat, trading Shadow for control. But in the meantime, while we're waiting for someone to reply, let's go ahead and do a gacha. Imagine we got control from this gacha. That'd actually be insane. Okay, that just wasn't control at all. All right, I've just hopped to a server and I believe this guy right here has control. And he put it down. Okay, bet. Let's hope this guy's not dumb. Mammoth, other player doesn't have enough space. Oh my god. Shadow, other player doesn't have enough space. He's really about to offer a dough. I'm putting a dough, bro. Please add something else to make this worth my time.
He's telling me add?
Bro. I can't believe these people. He jumped. Oh my god, bro. Average second C trading experience. I add a dough for a fruit that's worth way less and has literally no demand. And bro is telling me to add. Anyone have control for trade? Please. Someone give me a good trade. I'm overpaying a lot. Someone put in chat trading control on Shadow for dough. Hey, I'll take that. Got this guy right here. Hopefully this dude ain't brain dead and try to ask for ads when I'm already taking an L here. Control, Shadow, add ghost. All right, ghost. There we go. Easy work. Easy work, boys. 3, 2, 1, and there we go. Let me go ahead and eat this thing finally. There we go. Control activated. Now, the control in this game doesn't have that many moves. We only have really like 3 attacking moves. Levitate, Echo Knife, and Gamma Rush. The other 2 are, you know, the room and the teleport. But let's go ahead and showcase that real quick while we're here. We have room, which can be held to make it bigger, but this is the maximum size of the room. Then we have levitate right here. You either summon a rock or you can summon objects that can be cut like trees and then you shoot them down. Honestly, this ability is not that good for grinding. If you've grinded with this to max like I have, you would know it's not fun. I got 18,000 fragments though. We should be able to get a stat reset with that. I think it's this NPC here, Plockster. I can refund your stat point. Okay, yep, perfect. All right, there we go. Melee defense fruit. And you know, let's head over to 3rd C. I'm not wasting no more time. All right, we're now in 3rd C. Let's go fight the first boss. Room. Boom. Let's do that. There we go. Levitate. You know, I'm just going to use my fighting style to get most of this guy. And I'm just going to kill him with the last ability with control. Boom. There we go. Luckily, levitate has no cooldown, so I can just spam it. That is one benefit to it, I guess. It's right around half health. Throw some god human moves in there. Boom. Here we go. This should be the last hit. And he's done for. See how much master we end up getting. And we get 122 mastery. We don't get our first one till 150. We'll go ahead and head over to the next boss. I don't know if y'all can tell. I haven't been sleeping, bruh. It's been 24 hours since I last slept. Ooh, wee, man. This is starting to get tiring. All right, W, we got the island empress here. Let's go ahead and pack her up real quick. Light work, light work. Let's make quick work of her, boys. Let's make quick work of her. Here we go. Levitate. And finally, she's done. 153 mastery. We got our second ability, Echo Knife. Let's go ahead and show that thing without further ado. Room. Echo Knife. Boom. Slam into him. Hit him with a barrage attacks. And then you slam him away, which allows you to combo extend afterwards. Got our next ability, Teleport at 250 mastery. That is going to be a minute. Fighting Big Mom right now. Here we go. Boom. Here we go. Levitate. Boom. And there we go. Big Mom done. Got to 188 mastery. Sheesh, bro. Oh my gosh. Might just fight a bunch of Big Moms over and over again, man. Just defeated another Big Mom. And we got to 215. Here we go. Another Big Mom down. 237. Another Big Mom. I should get to 250 off this. And there we go. We unlocked our next ability. We've now unlocked Teleport, which, as you may suspect, it's just a teleport, which can cover the entirety of the room. Has a very low cooldown too, so pretty useful. But we have one last ability to unlock, and that's Gamma Rush at 350 masters. We gotta get 100 more. Now we have the final boss of the video, boys. Soon as I get done fighting her, we'll have that last move 100%. Levitate. One more levitate. There we go. 354. Ooh-wee. This was a grind, man. I ain't gonna lie. We unlocked the final ability, Gamma Rush. Let's check it out real quick. Let me activate the whole room. Gamma Rush. Boom. And look at this. This is actually the coolest ability in the entire control kit, boys. See that? And it hits anyone in the entire room, so it has a big AoE. Now, I'm gonna be honest, control is really bad for grinding. Moves are pretty outdated. I've never PP'd with it, so we're gonna go do that right now. We're gonna see how it is in combat. Now, I feel like I'm about to get packed up in the worst way imaginable because control is just not known to have PvP capabilities, but I guess we're about to mess around and find out. My friend Rip Mirage is joining the server, 15 million bounty player, and he said 1v1 me for the vid. All right, man, I can't find anyone else. I'll go ahead and 1v1 you. No countdown, just go, bro, just go. Let's see how good this thing could do in PvP. Make sure I'm gone. Boom. What the? Okay, buddy. Here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna abuse the hell out of my teleport ability. That way this man can just not keep up with me. Like, look at this. Hit him with these. Injection shot. Got him there. Boom. Teleport here. So far, we're not doing like too bad, I ain't gonna lie, but it's literally because I'm just like spamming and running. Like, okay. Oh, I actually got him. I actually got him. Oh my gosh. Boom. Boom. Oh, we're cooking. Oh my God, my room. Teleport over here. Boom. Got him there. Boom. 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 Go like this. Boom. Oh, couldn't hit that. Boom. 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 Ooh, wait. Yo, we're actually cooking. Levitate. Go over here. Hold on. He ain't gonna see this coming. Got him there. And injection shot. Boom. Yo. I know this man's struggling right now. I know this man's feeding right now for that W. Okay. Hit him with this snipe. Boom. Oh my God. That is so crazy. Bro, just literally got out of my thing, bro. Got him there. Boom. And GG. I'm taking that. 17K bounty, bro. I'm taking that. GG, bro. GG. What I've deduced from that fight is that control is actual duty water for PvP. I'm not gonna lie. And for that, I ain't gonna lie, this ain't much above King's Legacy. For the first time in a while, I'm gonna have to give Bloxers a bad rating. We're gonna give this a 6 out of 10. It is very outdated. Don't got an awakening. Move sucks. Sucks for grinding and PvP. 6 out of 10, man. 6 out of 10. Final rating of the video. There you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Fruit Battlegrounds got first place. A One Piece gang got second place. And Bloxers, sadly, got third place. Comment down which fruit y'all want me to master every One Piece game next. But with that, I'll see y'all later.